The cost of higher education is on the rise, so is the amount of debt students are piling up due to college loans. According to a new report from the College Board, tuition and fees at public universities increased 8.3% this year. That's twice the rate of inflation. And students are now leaving college with an average of $22,000 in debt. Here to talk about the cost of a college education and how to pay for it is Dr. April Osborn, Executive Director of the Arizona Commission for Postsecondary Education. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Nice to be here.
You're here talking about a Section 529 savings plan. What is that?
I am. In 1998, the federal government recognized that education costs were escalating, and they needed a way for moderate income families to prepare for these expenses. 80% of all financial aid comes from the federal government, but it goes to low income families. So they set up a tax advantaged way for people to put money aside over time and prepare for those expenses.
Now, you put the money aside and you can go to any college of your choice?
Yes.
Any
accredited college.
Accredited college, mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. As far as Arizona's 529 plan, there are other states with their own 529 plans as
there
well?
There are 529 plans.
Almost everyone's got one.
two of them consolidated.
Yeah. What differentiates Arizona's plan?
Well, our plan has one of the largest breadth of choices. We have three different program providers. These are financial institutions that manage the assets. We have also $623 million in assets, representing about 66,000 students' accounts. That plan, because we have so many choices, allows a family to determine what risk level they want, mm-hmm. and what kind of investments they're comfortable with. And we have two CDs. We were talking earlier about safety.
Yes.
We have CDs offered through the 529 plan that are FDIC insured. And that's on a lot of people's minds right now. So the principal is insured.
Yeah.
The interest is not.
Interest is not. And not all of the 529 plan. There are other aspects in the 529 plan that aren't insured as well. The CDs are.
The CDs are, yeah. Yes. We have mutual funds in a variety of choices as well.
Is there a minimum investment required?
There is, but you can open an account for as little as $15 a month.
$15 a month?
$15
That's a minimum investment.
Uh-huh.
And are there income restrictions?
No, there are not income restrictions. So anybody that wants to put money away is allowed to put money away.
And the commission's role in this and in helping families pay for college, talk to us about that.
Well, the Arizona Commission for Postsecondary Education is the identified agency in the state to deliver student financial assistance, and that includes grants, forgivable loans, and the 529 plan. So that's the core responsibilities of our organization, and we're invested in college access.
I was going to say, has that work changed here over the past few years?
Oh my goodness, yes. Our grants are down 78%.
My goodness.
Which gives us even more pause to think about the 529 plan. And we're grateful that we have a chance to talk to people about it, because the costs are going up even higher in Arizona than the numbers that you said, because we had such low cost private institutions. Mm-hmm. They're no longer low cost, they're slightly above average. And our parents are not necessarily informed until maybe the year before college, and they have some challenges.
More information on these 529 plans, where can people go?
You go to www.az529.gov.
AZ529.gov. Mm-hmm. While we got you here, the president today, I believe, talked about speeding up a loan repayment program. This payment program is based on income, but basically speeding up the process here. Talk to us about that.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah, we were celebrating in my office earlier. This is great news. It actually came out yesterday. But several things. First, those that have loans that are non-consolidated, they're allowing loans that were given by banks. Mm-hmm. We've just changed from independent loans and federal loans to all loans coming through the federal government. And they are encouraging consolidation. And when students consolidate, they may get as much as a half a percentage interest rate reduction.
Interesting. Correct me if I'm wrong here now. Debt forgiven after 20 years, if it's a 10% payment per month, something along those lines?
That's the income-based repayment program. And that was instituted like a year ago. And now he's going back and moving the timeline up. So it goes to 2012 and changing the terms to benefit students. And the way they're being changed is what happens is your discretionary income is figured, and then you are expected to pay at least 15% of that discretionary income for 25 years in the original program. And then yesterday he announced that it would be 20 years and only 10%. So that allows you to pay a lower amount per month, and at the end of 20 years, it's forgiven whatever remains.
And you said that your office, there was a big cheer when this was announced and you got the information. Why was it?
Well, we talk to students and we talk to families all the time, and our student loan debt is higher than the national average. We're sitting at about $27,000 per student, $27,000 per student. So we have lots of conversations about loans. And also, the consolidation is a great thing because it's very confusing to students to have three different payees, and often they then end up defaulting or missing a payment, and it costs them more.
Okay. Once again, that website for the 529 plan.
Let me try that again. www.az529.gov.
All right. Very good. Good to have you on the show. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.